Mammals come in splendid variety, from the massive blue whale to the tiny deer mouse. Nearly all mammal mothers have live birth and all produce milk for feeding their young. At least some part of their bodies are typically covered with hair or fur at some point in their lives. And all mammals are endotherms, which means they can generate heat to maintain their warm-blooded body temperatures. But tragically today, nearly one quarter of all mammals are threatened with extinction, including at least 65 species in the United States alone. Scientists have estimated the total mass of all mammals on Earth. They discovered that human beings make up 34% of this biomass. Domesticated mammals account for 62%, which means only the remaining 4% are wild species. In the forests of New England, wild American black bears live in close proximity to humans. These bears are constantly threatened by pollution, vehicles, and habitat loss, and black bear cubs are increasingly becoming orphaned. Today, I'm visiting the Killam Bear Center, where some of these bear cubs are given a second chance at survival. So this very precocious, absolutely adorable black bear cub is Marlo. This is Ethan Killam. And essentially, Ethan, you are Marlo's stepmom, aren't you?
Yes, I'm the primary caregiver for the cubs. So basically, I'm trying to be the best facsimile to a mother bear that I can be. So I'm feeding them, I'm introducing them to wild foods, wild things from the environment, stuff that they can play with.
Hi, Marlo. No nipple, no. That's not, no, please. No, Marlo, no. So your instinct is to interact, but we don't want to interact. We want this bear to discover that human beings aren't a part of his future success in life, right, Ethan?
Right.
We want him to be wild.
He'll be released at about 18 months of age, and then he'll have all the tools to be a perfectly wild bear.
Marlo, what are you doing? Marlo, please get off the cameraman. Marlo is still too young to be released, but today is a special day for two cubs named Flower and Dover. Today, they're going back in the wild, and that's what we're about to do right now. For both our safety and the safety of these cubs, Flower and Dover will need to be sedated. To do this, Ryan will use a long pole fitted at the end with a small syringe of fast-acting sedative. So what Ryan needs to do is get close to these bears, give them a quick poke, they'll go to sleep, and all will be good. No one likes getting a shot, especially a bear cub. Success, Ryan?
I think so.
I'm gonna wait till he starts to get a little tipsy, which he is right now. We wanna be there so when the bear goes to sleep, he doesn't fall and hurt itself. The sedative works very fast and makes Flower a little dizzy. But don't worry, we won't let him get hurt. We take Flower outside, where the wildlife team will give him his final checkup. So our first bear is nicely situated. Now, let's go get the next bear. All right. Okay, now it's time for bear number two. Ryan's gonna get in position. Thankfully, Dover's found a little corner to curl up in, so getting him outside will be much easier.
All right, if you just lower it down.
Okay, I got it. All right. They are just such beautiful, beautiful creatures. So precious, such an important part of our wild legacy. And to be a part of this program, it's amazing. So what you have to remember is that these bears are no longer in control in the way their head is angled, their airway is opened or closed, and we have to constantly be vigilant to make sure these creatures aren't overheating, aren't stressed, and are sleeping safe and sound. The team carefully records the cubs' temperatures, heart rate, and size, what we call biometrics. Finally, it's time to give these cubs a small tag on each ear so they can be identified in the future.
Ben, why is this so important? Why do we need to tag their ears like this?
Well, this is how we know what happens to them. It also tells us if they get in a conflict situation, they can be identified. We have that for our record. We need that information to know how successful the program is. These are unusual animals. We can have 15 or 20 of them together and they make friends. They're all individuals. They all have their own personalities. Every one of them is a character. These guys are beginning to wake up, so it's time to put them in the trailer.
All right, our bears are stirring. So I got Dover.
With some precious cargo in the back, we make our way into Vermont, to the very same woods where Flower and Dover were originally rescued.
This is the moment we've been waiting for, and these young bears, Ben, they're ready to go.
They're ready to go.
All the energy, the expertise, the TLC, this is what it's all about. All right, you ready?
Yep.
All right, let's do it. Oh, there you go.
One.
There Flower goes. I think, Ben, if anyone was wondering if these bears were truly wild, this answered their question, didn't it?
They're definitely truly wild. They just had to have a helping hand.
One look back, that, my friends, is a beautiful moment. That was great.